Well, welcome everyone to the Rutherford Congregational Church. Today is a special day because we're welcoming a little one into the household of the Christian faith.
Amen.
The sacrament of baptism is ancient. It's now used to bless and dedicate children to the Lord. And it's also an opportunity for us to reaffirm our baptism covenants, to do good and resist evil in the world. Today we'll also continue to celebrate the Easter season, the season of new beginnings, the season we celebrate the beginnings of the early church, and how the Spirit of God moved among nations. We celebrate victory of life over death. We celebrate new life in Jesus Christ. New life in Christ that is symbolized in the act of baptism. There are currently no state COVID restrictions for communal worship. But as always, we encourage you to do what feels most comfortable for you. So if you choose to wear a mask or social distance, you may do so without judgment. If you want to hug or kiss other people, feel free to do so, but ask permission first in case they are one of those who are social distancing. We each take personal responsibility for our individual health, and there is no judgment here. As always, our worship team hopes to provide you with a worship experience that is epic. Epic stands for experiential, participatory, image-rich, and connective. A note about our worship music. Our worship team attempts to provide a wide variety of music, from traditional to contemporary and everything in between. We hope to have something for everyone. We encourage you to make requests and dedicate a favorite song to a loved one if you wish. Everyone is welcome to participate in worship at whatever level feels most comfortable for you. And even if you sit quietly in the pews, or if you are at home on Zoom, good morning, Jackie. May you feel God's presence as we join together in worship. For a copy of today's order of worship, or to view us on YouTube, you can go to our website, www.rccucc.com. And as a reminder to you that here in this local congregation of the United Church of Christ, no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcomed here. You know, there's a whole row in the front row. Alicia, yeah. There's a whole row right up here in the front if they'd like.
Yes, thank you very much, yeah.
Our immediate family and our Bethlehem baby have just arrived. So I'm going to take one moment to hand something to them. Good morning, beautiful. And Dee, you'll get full programs in a little while. Now let us begin our worship with our musical prelude, asked by Anthony Evans. Thank you.
given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be open to you. Just ask. Just ask. Ask and it will be given to you. See and you will find. Knock and the door will be open to you. Just ask. Just ask. For everyone who asks receives, and everyone who seeks will find.
Thank you.
rise to your feet for our call to worship. It can be found, it will be found on your screen to the to your right. If you have your bulletins, it can be found on page 3. I will read the part that says L, that means leader, and P is in bold, and that is your part. I hope to hear your voices to praise out loud. Praise the Lord.
Praise the Lord from the heavens. Praise God from the heights.
Praise the Lord, you angels, sing praise, you heavenly host.
Praise the Lord, O sun and moon. Join in song, O shining stars.
Praise the Lord, snow and rain. Blow loud, wind and storm.
Praise the Lord, O trees. Dance with joy.
Praise the Lord, women and men, rejoice, children and rulers.
Praise the Lord, weak and strong, sing for joy, timid and bold.
Praise the Lord, mothers and aunts, praise the Lord, grandfathers and cousins.
Let all creation praise God's name,
praise the Lord. You may be seated. And hear now our opening prayer. Pray with me. God of all humanity, God of all creation, you make your home with us, within the hearts of all your creation. We come today to celebrate the vastness of your creative love and to especially celebrate new life in Jesus Christ. Jesus showed tender mercy to children and instructed us to enter his kingdom as the young ones do, with open hearts and open minds. Like a mother, you nurture your children, giving them life, teaching them to love. Your love extends to all nations and to all people. Come and dwell among us today and make all things new. Amen.
Amen.
And our opening hymn can be found in your hymnals number 526. We will sing it twice through. We are marching to the light of God.
Any children that want to come up, come on up with
and
our
if
kids.
Any children
we can come up here with our tambourines.
We can sing with
old or young, it doesn't matter.
Come on,
if you want to come up.
Come on.
Let's turn around.
Come on.
We're going to help lead. If you don't
our children always help us lead our songs.
This is the baby's family. Can we share with them? Violet, where's yours? Go run and get it. All right, and if you don't have a tambourine, get off. Right along with it. All right? We are marching. Awesome. We're ready.
Always enjoy with when our children sing praises to the Lord. Amen. You can keep them till later. You can play them anytime during service you'd like. It is now time for the reading of our sacred scriptures. Our contemporary reading today will be read by Tammy Jackson, and they are the words of Marion Wright Edelman, founder of the Children's Defense.
Children must have at least one person who believes in them. It could be a counselor, a teacher, a preacher, a friend. It could be you. You never know when a little love, a little support will plant a seed of hope. We must not, in trying to think about how we can make a big difference, ignore the small daily differences we can make, which over time add up to big differences that we often cannot foresee. It's so important not to let ourselves off the hook or to become apathetic or cynical by telling ourselves that nothing works or makes a difference. Every day, light your small candle. The inaction and actions of many human beings over a long contributed to the crises our children face, and it is the action and struggle of many human beings over time that will solve them with God's help. So every day, light your small candle. Listen for what the Spirit is saying to you. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Thank you, Tammy. And our New Testament scripture today, as we have been reading from the book of Acts during this Easter season, will be read by Phil Reynolds, Acts chapter 11, verses 1 to 18.
Peter's report to the church at Jerusalem. Now the apostles and the brothers and sisters who were in Judea heard that the Gentiles had also accepted the word of God. So when Peter went up to Jerusalem, the circumcised believers criticized him, saying, "Why did you go to uncircumcised men and eat with them?" Then Peter began to explain it to them step by step, saying, "I was in the city of Joppa praying, and in a trance I saw a vision. There was something like a large sheet coming down from heaven, being lowered by its four corners, and it came close to me. As I looked at it closely, I saw four-footed animals, beasts of prey, reptiles, and birds of the air. I also heard a voice saying to me, 'Get up, Peter, kill and eat.' But I replied, 'By no means, Lord, for nothing profane or unclean has ever entered my mouth.' But a second time the voice answered from heaven, 'What God has made clean, you must not call profane.' This happened three times. Then everything was pulled up again to heaven. At that very moment, three men sent to me from Caesarea arrived at the house where we were. The Spirit told me to go with them and not to make a distinction between them and us. These six brothers also accompanied me, and we entered the man's house. He told us how he had seen the angel standing in his house and saying, 'Send to Joppa and bring Simon, who is called Peter. He will give you a message by which you and your entire household will be saved.' And as I began to speak, the Holy Spirit fell upon them just as it had upon us at the beginning. And I remembered the word of the Lord, how he had said, 'John baptized with water, but you will be baptized with the Holy Spirit.' If then God gave them the same gift that he gave us when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that could hinder God?" When they heard this, they were silenced, and they praised God, saying, "Then God has given, even to the Gentiles, the repentance that leads to life. Listen for what the Spirit is saying to you. Amen."
Amen.
Amen. Anyone came in after the beginning of service, welcome. Welcome to the Rutherford Congregational Church, and we are all glad that you morning's scripture reading is again an occurrence that happened in the early church. Just weeks after the resurrection, Peter and the rest of his disciples were spreading good news about Christ throughout Jerusalem and all of these backwater neighboring towns up in the Jewish community surrounding Jerusalem. If you remember last week, Peter was in Joppa, where he had raised Lydia, or Dorcas, from the dead. And in the scripture reading today, he is still in Joppa. While he's there, he goes to sleep and he has this fantastic vision. In his dream, the Lord shows him all of the beasts of the world, reptiles and birds and various types of creatures. And they descend from heaven, which look like a sheep, like being held by four corners. And it gets lowered down right above the Apostle Peter. In his dream, the Lord showed him the vastness of creation. Now remember, in Jewish custom, it was forbidden to eat hoofed animals or shellfish or any number of other types of food. There were strict dietary laws which determined things that were clean and things that were unclean. So Peter refuses. Now Jesus, God tells Peter in verse 7, kill and eat. And Peter refuses by saying, by no means, Lord, nothing profane or unclean has ever entered my mouth. And the Lord has to tell Peter three times. Remember, we all know the Apostle Peter, and he was a pretty hard-headed dude. And he says, God says to him, what God has made clean, you shall not profane. So what does the strange vision mean? Remember, Jesus and all his disciples were Jews. They were people of the law. They had strict set of rules and regulations set down in the Torah, specifically the books of Deuteronomy and Leviticus, which told them what to do, how to behave, and what rules to abide by. But God was doing a new thing. God, through Jesus Christ, was doing a new thing. The old laws were now covered by God's grace and God's mercy. Through Jesus Christ, people were freed. They were freed from the rules that dictated their behavior, and Jesus offered to them and to us a new covenant. Can anyone remember what that covenant is? It's real simple. What's the new covenant? Love God, love neighbor. As simple as that. When we live by love, all of the other commandments, the commandments against lying and stealing and coveting and disrespect, all of those other things take care of themselves when you live by love. Now, the Jews and other had other restrictions besides not what to eat and what not to eat. Over and over in the Gospels, Jesus is criticized for socializing with unclean people. Tax collectors, prostitutes, poor people, lepers, people with disease, people who were outside of the social classes, outside on the margins of society. And Jesus was criticized for socializing with those people. So herein lies the second lesson. Verse 11 says, at that very moment, three men sent from Caesarea arrived to the house where we worked, where Peter was. And the Spirit told Peter to go with them and not to make a distinction between them and us. The second lesson is about making distinctions between us and them. So who are them? One rule I try to live by is not to talk about people who are not in the room. And we've had this conversation in coffee hour, we've had this conversation at council meetings, we've had this conversation in the church, in our homes, in our families. Why are we talking about someone who is not in the room? Why are we talking about a group of people who are not represented in the room? Another question to ask is, who are they? They are trying to take away my rights. They are trying to take away my job. They are draining the system. They are ruining my neighborhood. Who are they? At our church, we say that no matter who you are or where you are on life's journey, you are welcomed here. Another saying of the United Church of Christ is that God's doors are open to all. We are pretty open to people of different races and sexual orientations. I challenge us to think of who is not in our circle. Could it be the immigrant, unfamiliar with our traditions and customs? Could it be youth, who listen to different music than we do? Could it be those of a lower social or economic standing? We all have some inbred prejudices. When someone tells me they don't have a prejudice bone in their body, I simply assume they have no bones. I challenge each of you to sincerely look inside yourselves, examine your own heart, examine your own actions in the world. I'll share a story about my friend Sammy. His real name is something else, but I'll call him Sammy. I know who Sammy voted for in the 2016 elections. It was not the same person I voted for in the 2016 elections. And Sammy has said some things that have turned my hair gray. But when I had eye surgery and I was blind in one eye, it was Sammy who drove from Garfield 40 minutes to Pompton Lakes to take me to the optometrist, to take me to the eye doctor, not once, not twice, but three times. So yes, there may be things that Sammy says that I may find a bit offensive. There may be things, we may not vote for the same political party. We may have different real world views about things. But Sammy showed the love of God when some of my holy roller friends were too busy with their lives to take time out to help someone in need. Our differences can run much deeper than race, nationality, gender. Do we consider the needs of those with limited physical abilities? We are now, the reason our sanctuary looks the way it does is that we are moving into some new and very exciting space. God willing, within the next 3 to 6 months or so, hopefully. We won't have the stained glass and the pews, but we will have a community of faith. We will have a gathering space that we can call home. And I guarantee you, it will be a space with doors wide open.
Amen.
So while we are looking at space, one of our major priorities is that it is barrier-free. Uh-oh, this says my battery's running low, guys. I'm going to disappear. Okay. While we look for space, we are consciously looking for space that is barrier-free, so anyone and everyone, even if you just walk with a cane, or maybe you don't see very well, or maybe your balance isn't too good, or maybe you're in a wheelchair, that our space is open and accessible to everyone. And that is an area of difference that sometimes people overlook. We embrace those with mental or emotional difficulties. We may appear to be a pretty sane lot, the better you get to know us, you may learn that not everyone is quite as mentally or as emotionally stable as we may appear on the surface, including myself. We even engage with those, and do we engage with those of different political perspectives? In our country today, I would say that the biggest obstacle to the kingdom of God are our political differences. On both sides, we are so sure that we are right and they are wrong, that we have divided this nation not in two, but into pieces. I can't even say that we are divided into two sides. We are fractured to the point where no one feels safe. So here in our scripture today, in verse 17, hear the words of Peter. If then God gave them, the men of Caesarea, the same gift that he has given us when we believed in the Lord Jesus Christ, who was I that I should hinder God? God has given every creature a gift. Not just those who belong to the Christian church, not just those who have singing voices or a certain eye color. Jesus has given a gift not to those who vote one way or another. Both of our Bible study groups have studied the Phoenix Affirmation, and the very first Phoenix Affirmation reads as such: walk fully in the path of Jesus without denying the legitimacy of other paths that God may provide humanity. As followers of Christ, we can walk fully in the steps of Jesus. But who are we to determine what God has placed in others' hearts? What God has spread around the world? We may have the way, but God may have many ways.
Amen.
Amen. And lastly, I lost page five. But lastly, as we welcome a new saint into our midst, think of how we can be as open and inclusive as possible. God, who had created everything in this planet, the water, the air, the light, the darkness, every living creature with hoofs, scales, or shells, every creature of every language, every custom, every sexuality, every human being holds the divine light of God. And who are we to hinder God?
Amen.
Who are we to judge or divide? Jesus Christ overcame death over 2,000 years ago in ancient Jerusalem, and yet his message of agape love has spread through the backwater towns surrounding Jerusalem, through Joppa, Caesarea, throughout Africa and Europe. This powerful ministry of Jesus Christ is extended to all. So who are we to hinder God? So friends, let us draw our circle wide. Let us extend the love of Christ even wider. Not for those who already believe. Not just to the old, but to the young. People we encounter along the way. In a little while, we will dedicate a new saint to the household of faith. Let us be glad and rejoice in this day that God's love is not limited to those in Jerusalem or Rutherford, that God's love is extended to all, and all means all.
Yes, yes, yes.
Amen?
Amen.
I'd like to invite Violet and Perry Bella to come up and lead us in a very special song that is dedicated to our children today.
Especially Amaya.
Especially Amaya Whitler. Amaya is out walking. We can pray for one another. I can direct you to page 11 in our bulletin, our joys and concerns. I invite you to keep your bulletins with you and pray for those during the week. Our two separate Bible study classes. Also, pray for everyone on our list. We pray for one another. We pray for the world. And we continue to ask all of you to keep those who are listed, who are called out. Doug is on from California on Zoom. Welcome, Doug. It's about 7 o'clock in the morning, your time, I think. God bless you. Thank you for Zooming in with us. So we pray for one another. Doug's prayer requests are actually in last week's, are in our Pastor Bible Studies prayer request. So I'm going to ask those of you on Zoom first if you have any joys to share, because we want to share in each other's happy moments as well as just all of the things that require supplication. So are there anybody, hi Andrea, I see Andrea Long is on as well. Are there any prayer requests or joys to share from our friends on, in our congregational friends on Zoom? Doug.
Yeah. Well, I see Sherry Dragic, you probably knew Sherry Dragic pretty much, you see that I've completed the work for my doctorate ministry degree, my dissertation's been accepted, and I'm going to be awarded the degree doctorate ministry in a ceremony in Oxford. I'm so excited and so blessed by the support of the Bible Study Group and those of you who are
proud. Yay, Dr. Doug! Are you transcribing?
Yes.
Okay. Dr. Doug's PhD.
I got it.
Okay. And today Carol Anderson is taking notes. So I'm going to ask everyone to speak slowly and clearly. Those of us in the sanctuary to come to this microphone so that we can record the joys and concerns clearly. Is there anyone else on Zoom? Andrea.
Hi, everybody. Last week my uncle fell off a ladder and he broke his neck. And he was alone at the time, so he suffered a concussion and did not receive medical care right away. So at the moment it seems that, I mean, he's fine. He's 75 years old with four broken vertebrae in his neck and a broken collarbone and a broken rib. He's as good as you might expect, though he looks like he was hit by a truck. So it is a joy that he's going to be okay. It looks like you're not going to have to operate. But still, obviously, we're all very concerned about him. So prayers for my Uncle John.
Uncle John, thank you, Andrea. Anyone else on Zoom? Jackie, Barb? Those of us in the sanctuary, please share your joys, your concerns, and prayer requests. Alicia.
My prayer today is from the Sunday school. The children today learned about John's dream of the world. And the kids wrote a prayer today, and I want to share it with you, of their dreams for the world. Ukraine and Russia to stop fighting. More kindness and love in the world. People who disagree, listen to each other with love. Clean water for everyone, fresh air. For people to stop treating animals and the earth badly. No littering anymore. Everyone has shelter. For the coronavirus to go away. To treat people nicely. No more gun violence. For everybody to have food. For everybody to have everything they need to survive, and for people to be compassionate for things they don't understand. And those are our children, and they're all under third grade. I mean, that's amazing that that's our future.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. You can lift up again and you can hear. I went to that Sunday school class again this morning. I go every Sunday morning on Zoom. It's on Zoom and it's live. And Alicia runs a wonderful Sunday school class. I encourage anybody to, you can all just get the number and come on in. Personal joy is that I got to go and spend time with my daughter and son-in-law, who I hadn't seen in a very long time. And it was just plain fun. We have had, there are always, my daughter has Huntington's disease. This is Huntington's Disease Awareness Month. And so a lot of things in their lives take a lot of effort and struggle, and they aren't the things you put up on the poster about how life is going to be good. But this was fun this week. I also would ask an ongoing prayers for decisions that are being made in this church, and in this church community, and in the greater community with regard to the use of this building, of the next step that we take into our new space. This is something that I would ask if we could pray about.
with great, great sincerity and faithfulness as we go along in these next few months.
Amen.
Would anyone like to share a joy or a concern? Anybody on this side? Bernard, come on up. And Bernard, once you get up there, stay up there, because you're going to be singing soon.
Tammy, I need that. Second.
Is that my grandson, Leo? Welcome.
First, I'd like to thank God for allowing me the opportunity to be here and share with you this morning. Last week, I couldn't make it because the last 2 weeks, my whole family, my four daughters, both my house and my daughter's house across the street were down with the flu, not the virus, with the flu. And our whole community up in Hilburn, New York, all suffering with a flu virus. And last week, I had to sing from home and worship from home on Zoom. But thanks to this wonderful church, we're still able to participate whether we can be here or not. But I thank God I could be here this morning. My other daughter said, stay home, Dad. But Tammy, my oldest daughter, she said, no, we're going to church. And I was so glad so I could be here for this wonderful baptismal service. And I thank God and I ask him to bless you all. And it's nice meeting you all.
Amen.
I'm just going to get out of the way.
Okay. I lost one of my longest and dearest friends, Julie Frankel, this week. And I asked for prayers for her wife, Sarah Lee. I asked for prayers for her son and daughter, Jason and Alyssa Frankel. They literally grew up since babies in diapers with my two sons. They're the same age as my two sons. Julie and I are the same age. We spent 20 years together as good friends, raising our kids and traveling around and doing things together. And it was an unexpected and so devastating loss to our family and extended family. So I asked for particular prayers for her wife and her two children, who are adult children now with the loss of their mom and my friend, Julie Frank.
Amen. Amen.
Andrea? Yeah, hi. I also wanted us to pray for the Black community of Buffalo, who was, you know, horribly attacked yesterday by a white supremacist.
And now I invite you to breathe deeply in your seats, to feel the Spirit of God in your heart and in your spirits, and feel the Spirit move within this space, that we may know God's presence, know God's will for us individually as a congregation, and that we spend a few moments giving our own private thanks to God, who is our creator, our redeemer, and our sustainer. A few moments of silence. we can join together in the prayer that Jesus taught his disciples to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. And it is now offering time. He is risen. Let us lay our treasure at his feet. Giving honor to the resurrected Christ, we offer these gifts of money, time, and talent to your work in the world. If you are watching on YouTube or watching us live stream on Zoom, please take this time now to log into our website, or you can use your telephones and log into PayPal, and or go to our website, www.rccucc.com, click on the donate link to make your offering. Or you can mail a check to RCC 251 Union Avenue, Rutherford, New Jersey, 07070, attention financial secretary. For those in the sanctuary, there are two, we're still doing the touch list. We're not, our ushers aren't passing the plate yet. We may start that up again soon. But there are two baskets at the rear of the center aisle. If you would like to stretch your legs and make a donation, you can do that at this time to the glory of God, to the building of his kingdom and the ministries of the church. And we will now ask Bernard to sing our offertory song, The Greatest Love of All.
Please bear with me. I have my cheat sheet here, but when you get old, you forget words. So I do have a backup.
Get right up to the mic.
Am I close enough?
Yes.
I'm going to try and sing for you The Greatest Love of All. I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show them all the beauty they possess inside. Give them a sense of pride to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how we used to be. Everyone's searching for a hero. People need someone to look up to. I never found anyone who fulfilled my needs. A lonely place to be, and so I learned to depend on me. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadow. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I live as I need. No matter what they take from me,
they can't
take away my dignity. Because the greatest love of all is happening to me. I've found the greatest love of all inside of me. I believe the children are our future. Teach them well and let them lead the way. Show all the beauty
to make it easier. Let the children's laughter remind us how it used to be. I decided long ago never to walk in anyone's shadow. If I fail, if I succeed, at least I know I live as I believe. No matter what they take from me, they can't take away my dignity. Because the greatest love of all is happening to me. I found the greatest love of all inside of me. The greatest love of all is easy to achieve. Learning to love yourself is the greatest love of all. And if by chance that place that you've been dreaming of leads to a lonely place, find your strength in the love.
Amen. Thank you, Bernard. I believe that children are our future. If we could all join on page 6 of our bulletins for our prayer of dedication. Generous God, we offer these gifts as a testimony to your glory and as a commitment as your disciples. Bless our gifts to your work in the world and to your reign here on earth. Through your blessings of our gifts, may death be destroyed and hope fill all creation. Amen. And now it is time for the moment we have all been waiting for. The baptism of Amaya Chanel Grace Pulley. I am going, Alicia, I don't know if I can bring this over. I think I can. I'm going to stand right here. Yep. I'm going to stand right here. And I am going to invite now the candidate for holy baptism, which is, oh, she's announcing herself. Amaya Chanel, please come forward with your parents. Adrian Laurie Pulley and Curtis Pulley. Amen. I invite you guys to say, hi, Mama. And I invite the godparents, Kanaya, Kiana, Kayan, and Velda. And Velda, I'm sorry, your name was on the top of the form and not in the correct line. And I'm going to ask you to join on this side of the baptismal font, the godparents. And then the parents, I'm at the grandparents, Deborah Lorick and Deidre Banton Pulley, to come up, the grandparents on the side. Everybody else on this side? And the two grandmas up on this side. And yep, on this side. And you should have a covenant. A covenant is a promise. It's a promise for, this is a draft, it's okay. It's a promise that we make to It's a promise that we make to Amaya, but it is also a reaffirmation of our own commitment to the Christian faith. It doesn't matter if we use water or not. It could be called a dedication. It could be called a christening. The point is that each child is blessed by God. Oh, she's telling me, speak into it. Okay, thank you, Ellen. That each child is blessed by God.
Amen.
And that we welcome them into the household of the Christian faith. And that is bigger than this church. It's not about the building that we're in or whether we're called Baptist or Episcopal or Presbyterian or Methodist. It doesn't matter that the household of faith is all of Christ's believers. So we open our doors wide. We open this welcome wide. We open this blessing wide. Now I have, does everyone have, this is our cards, which I will prompt you in a little bit while because everybody at RCC participates in everything. This is not just performed by a priest or a sacred duty that only a certain ordained person can do, but that each believer has a part in. So the family have a set of questions that I would like to ask as the presider, and the parents, godparents, and grandparents all get to respond together. Is that okay?
Yes.
Okay. So the candidate for holy baptism will now be presented, and the parents present.
We present Amaya Chanel to receive the sacrament of baptism.
Do you accept God, your creator, Jesus of Nazareth, as your redeemer, and the God, the Holy Spirit, to guide your life? This is for everybody.
We accept the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit into our lives and the life of this child.
Will you be responsible for seeing that Amaya is brought up in the Christian faith and community and Christian life?
We will, with God's help.
Will you, by your prayers and witness, help her to grow into the full stature of Christ?
We will, with God's help.
Do you renounce the evil powers of this world that corrupt and destroy life and creatures of God?
We renounce them.
Do you renounce all sinful desires and temptations that separate you from your true self and from the love of God?
We renounce them.
What is your desire for this child?
Our desire for Amaya is to be accepted as God's own child. For her to be baptized into the household of faith and blessed by God's Holy Spirit through this baptism by water.
And what is your commitment to this child?
We commit to raising Amaya in the Christian faith. We commit to love her, guide her, discipline her, support her, and to help her grow into the woman that God has planned for her to be.
And I will now give a thanksgiving over the water. We thank you, God, for the gift of water. On it, the wind danced at the dawn of creation. Through it, you led the children of Israel out of bondage and into the promised land. In it, Jesus received the baptism of John and was anointed by the Holy Spirit. By it, you sustain all living things in all its diversity. Bless this water, which quenches our thirst, fills us with life. In it, may we die to all that destroys life. Through it, may we embrace all that renews and makes life abundant. Amen. And now for your part. This is a big blessing. You get blessed. You get blessed many, many times. And for the congregation, do you renew your vows of your baptisms to resist evil and work for good?
We do.
Do you understand that the act of baptism seals what Scripture proclaims, that God's redeeming grace is offered to all people? Baptism is a God's gift of grace to us, and it is God who summons us to respond to his love.
We do.
Do you, as a family of faith, congregation, community, vow to God to help this child grow in Christ to learn the word and the works of our faith?
Yes, we do.
And the people will pray. We receive you into the community of the Christian faith. May you learn among us never to sell yourself short. May you risk something big for something good. May you help you that world is too dangerous for anything but truth and too small for anything but love.
Amen.
Amen. And now the baptism. Amaya, can you come to Granny? Can you come to Granny? It's okay. It's going to be really fast, I promise. Amaya Grace Pulley, I baptize you, this is really warm, in the name of the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God and Mother of us all, and you are now sealed. I'm going to turn this way. Open up the torture in the baby, and you are now sealed. You are now sealed by baptism, marked as Christ's own little girl forever and ever.
Amen.
Have the tears.
Amen. Let us pray. I'm going to let you go to Mama. It's okay. I'm sorry. Holy One, we thank you that by water and the Holy Spirit you have bestowed your grace on this new saint. Sustain her, O God, with your still small voice. Give her an inquiring and discerning heart, that courage to persevere, and a spirit to know and to love you, and the gift of joy and wonder in all of your works. May we now... Can I come back? Just for a minute. And we're just going to... She's saying hello to everybody. Say hello to everybody. Yeah. Just like the camera. There you go. God bless you. God bless the family.
Amen.
Amen. And while you're here for the family, I want to present you with her official baptismal certificate. And as the petals of this flower bloom into full bloom, may Amaya bloom into the full woman of grace that God would have her to be. Children with my blessing. Amen. Thank you. Receive this blessing. As God revealed to Peter, the love of God is open to all. Go forth with joy and thanksgiving as we welcome this new child into the household of faith. Rejoice and be cheerful and share God's love with everyone you meet. Amen.
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 Do we have any announcements? Any announcements from the congregation? Come on up. Carol and Phil have announcements.
Just a reminder that our church council meets this Wednesday evening. This is the group primarily for whom I was asking you to pray because we deal with the business of the church, the leadership of the church. So Wednesday evening at 7 o'clock, actually, I'm going to open the meeting. So I will say that again later and several times during the week with the agenda.
Just from a message from the worship team, those of you who have copies of the congregational part of this baptism, we have three baptisms next week. So if you could please leave the congregational part on the back table, we're going to use it again next week. Thank you.
This announcement has an example of one way that the church and community can get a little closer together. And what I'm referring to is the spring concert of the Rutherford Community Band, which is not going to be in Rutherford. It's going to be in Clifton. We have not been able to use Rutherford High School because of COVID for many months. But the concert's going to be at the Grace Episcopal Church. If you know where the Daughters of Miriam Nursing Home is, I go up the Parkway short distance to exit 155B, turn right, and the Daughters of Miriam Nursing Home will be right there. You go another 3/10 of a mile, and you'll be at the Grace Episcopal Church. The concert is Saturday afternoon at 2:30, and we're going to have some rather magnificent pieces included in the program. Beethoven's Egmont Overture, a nice transcription for concert band, and William Walton's coronation procession ceremony. It's kind of a long piece because it's supposed to be for a coronation and people keep marching along, but it's a great work for me, and I hope that some of you will be able to come and hear us.
Amen. Amen.
And for all our guests today, you're always welcome to join us at any Sunday. Next Sunday, God willing, we'll be outside for other baptisms, but you're always welcome to join us at any time. Let us conclude our service with our postlude, Baptized by Zach Williams.
Church on the new, man at the altar, never did have been filled.
Congregational Church, we believe in cake before lunch. So I invite you all to fellowship with us. Big Jim has made a big pot of coffee back there. We have bagels, and our worship team has purchased a cake for Amaya. So please join us for fellowship in the community. And thank you all for coming, and I'm happy to see all of you on Zoom. We'll see you next week. God bless.